Good morning and happy July 16th. Today's going to be a little different of a video because the kiddos are still asleep. It's about 9 o'clock over here in Anthony, Texas, which is a little bit north of El Paso. And fun fact, we are on mountain time, which is about 3 hours ahead of what we're used to. So I think the kiddos are a little bit set off with our time. So that's why we were great and let them sleep in. So we might actually just kind of push in the sleep outs and get on the slide outs and just get on the road from here. We are headed to Phoenix, Arizona. Last night we stayed over in, it's called Anthony KOA, and it is by far the largest campground I think we've ever stayed in. Has a beautiful view of the mountains in the background, and this morning we got a chance to see the sunrise at like 6:11 this morning, and which I'll post a video of that too because it was also absolutely beautiful. We kind of got lucky with our spot. We had to do a little switcheroo because the first spot we were assigned to was right next to like a huge truck, so we couldn't put our slide outs in. So we wound up getting this very end spot, which was perfect because as soon as we opened our door, this was our view. So other fun fact, yesterday when we got here, it started this crazy downpour, so I'm gonna post some pictures later on today, and it was just absolutely amazing seeing the actual rainstorm come through and come across the desert. We also got some really cool pictures because there was a triple rainbow. So there was a double rainbow and then there was one little guy hiding over there. So we took some really cool pictures of it and some really awesome videos of the lightning storm that came across. So I'll post those as well. But fun fact I mentioned earlier I was gonna say is that El Paso is nicknamed the Sun City. It has 340 days of sunshine, and we seem to bring the rain. So it was kind of interesting that we got to see both aspects because it was 115 degrees, and then as soon as it rained, it was absolutely gorgeous. And even this morning, it's 75 degrees. I think today the high is 90. Unfortunately, we're not going to be sticking around to enjoy that desert cool breeze, but that's fine. Phoenix should be nice and interesting. And like I said, we'll post some videos later. I'll do a 360 so you can see kind of where we are and before I scoot out for the day and get on the road. So again, this is kind of where we are. Ooh, that sun is strong. So we only had the one neighbor, which was great. And that would be our 360. The cool thing about this place, I do want to kind of point out, is right over here, I'm hoping you can see it, right over there is this huge dog park. So we did bring Tootsie over there. They had some balls and some hydrants and some obstacles for the dogs to kind of play around with, and it was kind of large. The only downfall is because we are in the desert, there is no pool, which is understandable because it will probably be like a mud hole or at this point because of all the dust and everything like that. So, and I do think the boys are gonna be pleasantly surprised because in Phoenix, that campground does have a pool, and hopefully, fingers crossed, we get there in time to kind of check it out. It is about a 6.5 hour drive from El Paso to Phoenix, so I don't think it would be altogether that rough. We did kind of hit a couple snafus just to give you a full update because I do mention all the cool and great stuff, but I do want to mention some of the crazy goofy stuff that has also happened on this trip to make it a true Griswold experience. Yesterday and the day before, I think I mentioned our generator is kind of wonky and it's kind of taunting Derek a little bit. So what happens, just to understand, is we have air conditioning in the front, right? So the motor works on the air conditioning for the driver and the passenger, but in the back of the motorhome, the generator runs the air conditioning unit. Luckily our refrigerator is dual action, meaning it can run back up on an inverter or propane. So the food I wasn't worried about, but it was 115, 120 degrees yesterday while we were driving, as well as the day before. So it got extremely hot inside the coach because the generator would go on for an hour, turn off. So like I said, it's been kind of wonky. So yesterday while we were driving here, we stopped at a Cummings. They kind of handle and service our generator. It's an Onan generator. So I have a huge shout out to them. They were absolutely helpful on the phone. They actually stayed open a little bit late for us because even though we were driving as quick as we could, we ran into, you know, a kind of delay. So we didn't get there until after they closed, but they were so amazing. They stayed open late for us to be able to pick up this part. We picked up a new carburetor. So fingers crossed, Derek installed it yesterday. So fingers crossed, it works today. We will let you know. But they were absolutely great. I was so happy that they stayed open for us. They were super helpful over the phone, making sure it was the right part so we didn't waste like a couple $100 on the wrong, you know, series, the wrong model. The other thing I meant to mention and I totally forgot is yesterday we pulled another audible for our pit stop. So we pulled an audible and got a chance to go to the War Angel Museum, which is basically a hangar and a little area that you can kind of go and explore all of the aircraft and some vehicles, like cars, of the World War II and Korean War era. They did have some stuff from the Vietnam War too, so it was great because Carter got a chance to kind of see all the planes. Our docent's name was Charlie and he was super cool. He answered all of Carter's questions and there was a few. So it was really great. Charlie was really interactive with Carter and just kind of going back and forth. They were asking questions. Carter was asking questions. Dylan wasn't a huge fan. He did enjoy the cars because they had a bunch of like old Jaguars. They had Oldsmobiles and kind of like the first vehicles, and he had a good time looking at that. But the helicopters, the planes, the aircraft, all of that was just absolutely awesome to see. So we did get a chance to do that pit stop and I'm super glad we did because like I said, Carter really enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. Derek did too. And Dylan got a chance to check out some stuff. So all around, I feel like it was a good pit stop and audible that we pulled. And I did want to shout that out because it's kind of off the beaten path. It was like an extra maybe 40 minutes for us for a drive. But like I said, it was totally worth it. And their hours were great. I was just really happy they were open because we needed to kind of take a break from just being drive. And unfortunately today on the way to Phoenix, there really aren't a whole lot of stops. We're trying to get a couple zoos in, but everyone seems to be closed. We're holding out for San Diego Zoo and checking every single day to make sure that they stay open because that's Dylan's, you know, mecca. He cannot wait to get into a zoo. So we're not really making any pit stops today, but like I said, I think the kids are going to be really psyched to get to the pool in the next RV campground that we're going to be in. So I plan on making like a huge dinner tonight, sit down, hang out at the campground and just kind of take it in. So I will post some videos, like I said, of the sunset. I will post some videos of the pictures that we took yesterday and as well as the lightning storm that we caught on video too. So look forward to that and I will talk to everyone tomorrow. Thank you for watching.